let's talk about what's new in SOLIDWORKS Electrical 2024. We have new additions to 2D schematics and SOLIDWORKS 3D as well. Starting with schematics, the update to 2D cabinets was now made so we can use auto balloon. When you use the auto balloons, they match up to the row numbers the footprints are linked to in a report. With this feature, we can choose leader styles, we can choose the different block shapes, as well as the block sizes. With the layouts, we can have our balloons organized along the top, the bottom, left-hand side, right-hand side, or in the square format. We also have the option to group balloons, ignore multiple instances, or choose to ignore terminals. So if I want to have one representation of the same instance or multiple instance, I can have that toggled on and I can choose to include or exclude my terminals from my report. This auto balloon layer will also exist on this layer, or we can put it on a different layer. And then we have the option to insert the report table as well. So I'm going to go ahead and insert this table at the bottom here. When looking at this table, we can see there's plenty of information here, including manufacturer part information. Now we can save some extra time because SOLIDWORKS has made it so we can delete manufacturer part information, and that will fully clear residual terminal numbers at the component level. So we'll save some time when we're clearing manufacturer part information. Another update SOLIDWORKS has included for us is representing component marks as a range in our reports. So what do I mean by this? Let's look at the table we just inserted. We have our manufacturer parts here, and we have our quantity and marks. When we have a quantity count of 3 or 1 or 2, it's easy to fit the marks for those components in this single cell. But when we have something like our WEGO 1201 terminal blocks with 17 of them in there, each individual mark for those 17 iterations is going to expand the cell or change the whole format of the table. The way we can represent this as a range is SOLIDWORKS has included an ellipse to represent a gap between the first and the last iteration of those terminal blocks. So this makes it easy to format, and it makes it easy to understand and follow all the different marks in this table. Let me open up a schematic and show some of the changes here as well. So we have a schematic here that represents our harness design. We have connectors, we have our wire harnesses or cables in between. And one update SOLIDWORKS has made is being able to move symbols using the arrow keys on the keyboard. So now I can move up, left, right, down, and I can adjust how my symbols are arranged in my schematic with only using my arrow keys. So that is a new function that SOLIDWORKS has made easier for us to access and easier for us to maintain and modify our drawing orientations or our schematic layouts from within our keyboard shortcuts. One thing to take note of as well is as I zoom in and as I zoom out, my grid does a much better job at auto sizing. So SOLIDWORKS has made improvements to that, especially making it easier for when we're working on larger displays. Having that scaling much quicker and much more intuitive is definitely helpful when referencing our drawings and our schematics. Now let's take a look at the 3D updates for our electrical project. Here we can see an arrangement of connectors for electrical harnesses. The first update I want to show is routing active location only. In the electrical tab here, we can see the location L2 and the components that are included in this location. When we go ahead and automatically route that harness, we can select the option to only route the active location. So let me go ahead and go to my route harnesses. And from within this feature tree selection, I can choose to route active location only. When I do that, it's going to focus only on location L2 that I have active, and it's going to route that accordingly. Now we can see that this harness has been routed for us, and it has followed that path for our location L2, and we notice that this harness was untouched. This harness didn't change, it wasn't moved, it wasn't rebuilt, because we focused primarily on location L2. The next update in 3D is to filter components or manufacture parts in the feature tree. So if I go to my electrical tab here, I have a new filter for manufacture parts. So I can choose filtering by association, accessory, auxiliary, or even manufacture parts that are excluded from the BOM. And when I use that, I can toggle this filter on and off, and it's going to apply those changes for me.